Ali Abdal is one of the most popular YouTubers right now, and he is very popular with his simplistic productive video. His video's thumbnails are very simple and attractive to the viewers, and often he uses similar kind of style of thumbnail for his videos. Now, I started a series called Creators Create Challenge, where I'm going to show you all of the process that what popular YouTubers do to create edit thumbnails for their videos and how they just go blow up with their thumbnails. So you can follow up the style and create your own style and just grow your channel easily. Now, first, I'm going to take some of the pictures of myself as like Ali Abdal, and then I'm going to choose this one. After that, with the image, I need icons, arrow pins, and also at the background for our world. After collecting all of those, now we are ready to start our video. Now for this video, I'm going to use the Photoshop, but this task you can also use the free version of Photoshop, which is called Photopia. It's very kind of similar, an online version. You can just use it as like Photoshop and do the same kind of process as like me. For first, we're going to create a document. To do that, go to the file and new over here, and then you can choose the custom size of full HD size. Now a lot of people are like to go with the HD version, but in my preference, I always like to go with the full HD version. It's give me a more range to work with. Then I'm going to create that. After that, here, now we're going to first use our model. As like Ali Abdal's video, as he is using, I'm using kind of similar photo that I took and which is I really like. Now you can see I just paint my image over there, and now first we need to remove the background of the image. To do that, it's a very easy way. We can use the paint tool, but for me it's a beginner tutorial. I'm going to use that quick selection tool. Then I'm going to go to the deselected mask. You can also find that over, go to the select and here cylinder and mask, then select the subject. It by one click we're going to select the model, and you can see it's kind of okay, but you can see there is some area need to be refined, as like over there and also in this part beard area and also that part. To do that, I'm going to use the brush tool. You can see it might be selected, that it need to be selected that brush tool. Then we're going to click right on our mouse, and it's going to open that like hardness. I'm going to increase the hardness around 50%. You can just skip it and then just click and drag. It will add the selection. You can see this part has been added. Now take your time and just add some of this area that you think it can be added. So I think this is okay. I need also to add this part. So do that just as like it is. Now this red part will be going to be removed, and also the only the visible area would going to be kept. So now here I think it's perfectly all right. You can see there are some issues, so we can fix it. Just click and drag. This is done, and I think I'm happy with that. Next, just go to the output over here. You can see it's going to be over there like this one. Just go here, output, select new layer with layer mask, and then just click. Now you can see we just remove the background. First, we're going to convert that image into smart object to keep that size accurate. Then go to the and take it here and paste it. Now then go to the edit and free transform. We need to reduce the size. You can just click and drag over here to reduce the size, like here. Just you can just make it a little bit bigger, smaller, and then place it. Now just want to make it a little bit bigger as it is, and also there is some area is need to be perfectly all right. Now again, we'll just make this on as a smart object. We're going to click on the thumbnail, double click, and it's going to open another one. Then just go here and create a new layer, like take it like a solid color. In this case, I'm going to go to white and take that into the back area. Now some of the area is need to be refined again, so we can do that easily. Select the layer mask, then select the brush tool, make it bigger, decrease the hardness, and then take it the black in the foreground color, and just remove some of this area. So after that, I think this is area is need to be okay, just a little bit. And then next step, we need to retouch our image. So to do that, just take this spot healing tool. Then we're going to select and remove those spots. First, select this layer, create a new layer. To do that in a non-destructive way, then select that sample all layer. Then create, just click and just make editing and remove those spots. Now after removing the spot, next I'm going to do some of the color adjustment. I can keep it is, but as like the Ali Abdal do, he use a lot of contrast and also color highlights on his face. So I'm going to do the same like that. For that, first we need to create a snapshot of that. First I'm going to off that layer, then press Shift Control Alt E on your keyboard. Is going to be on Mac, Shift Control Shift Command Option E on their keyboard. First then to convert that into a smart object, I can convert that, but yeah, for me I need to be create a duplicate layer, then convert that into smart object. And also by this one, go to the image adjustment and invert. You can use that Control I keyboard, then change the blending mode and a vivid light. After that, go to the filter, others, high pass, increase the high pass a little bit, and then again go to the filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. This time just increase that where the details might be gone, and I think it's okay. Next step is to just we're going to add a negative layer mask. To do that, first apply a layer mask, then select the layer mask and Control I to invert that. Next step, take the brush tool, use the foreground color is white, opacity around 30% to 40%, and then apply that smoothness, face smoothness into the face area. And I think we don't need the hand part, so I'm going to only target the face. Next, we're going to create a contrast, and also we call that dodge and burn technique. So just go to the adjustment layer, take the curve. Now take that and make it highlight a little bit. Change the blending mode into just linear dodge or something color screen. I think linear dodge is okay. Now decrease the opacity, and I think it's perfectly alright, 8%. Now we're going to remove this from the certain part. To do that, just take the brush tool, foreground color is black, and then just remove that part. I think it's okay for now. Then again go to the adjustment layer. Now this time take the curve tool, and this time change the blending mode into linear burn. Now decrease the opacity and just increase it certain part, and then we're going to invert that layer mask. Just again Control I, and now take the time and apply that color, burn color, into the side part of that. Now if I just turn that out, and you can see some of the difference, and just want to make sure the difference is visible. And also this time take your time and apply that color, and I think it's perfectly all right. Now we can do other color grading in the next part. Now just crop off that layer by pressing yes. You're going to save that, and now you can see all of the things is apply on that. Next we're going to create the background. Select the background, then go to over here, take the background. I'm using a simple backdrop over here, and now I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, and I think it's okay. Next we're going to apply Gaussian blur. Go to the filter, blur, and take the Gaussian blur, increase the Gaussian blur a little bit. And then we're going to introduce some of the color. To do that, let's create a blank layer, then take the brush tool, and now here we're going to choose a color like bright blue, and it's okay. Then just apply that color, and this time take a white color, and now change the blending mode into color dodge or something, whatever screen color. I think linear is doing great. And now this time just take your time and apply that color a little bit certain area to just pop up the cat. We're going to use the overlay. Overlay is good, and I think what should it going to be work on overlay or something. It's all right. Next step is, and then we're going to add another color over here, like just a complementary color, which is be yellow or any kind of other color like you want. I think overlay is working good. Next we're going to use our icons over the design. Now we're going to create some of the angles by press Ctrl. You can just over here press T. I'm going to skew that and a little bit just. It's already been done. Next, we're going to apply motion blur over here. Just select that for the filter blur and take that motion blur. I can just apply the motion a little bit. We can increase the size over there. Okay, then apply that filter. Now you can see we just applied our color. Next step is to apply that icon in the back area. So we have that icon over there, and just over that we're going to do vertically and make it a little bit bigger. And I think it's that arrow is a little bit big, so we need to adjust that. We're going to apply a layer mask over here. Then we're going to take the brush tool, increase the opacity, hardness, and then we're going to sim. Now we're going to apply white color. Press double click over here, then apply color overlay, and we're going to introduce white color. Now, as you can see, we need to do some of the adjustment over there. And I think it's okay. And we're going to apply also a drop shadow. Double click over here and then apply drop shadow. Change that color into black. Then into multiply, a darken, and then just a little bit. That would be fine, I think. Next step is to apply. I think the arrow can be changed. I'm just using as a reference, and then also I'm going to use that number of followers. So do that. So over here 0, and then make it up bigger, and then just to be bold, I think it's extra bold black. I think extra bold will be perfect. Yes, I think it's okay. Then over here, I think it's need to be make a little bit smaller. 1M, I think it's perfect. What about changing the font? I think we're going to Roboto. Roboto font, I think is work good, and make it smaller. And decrease that gap. And I think I'm not happy with that font, so I'm going to try another font. It's called Poppins. -35 would be perfect. And then I'm going to change the color into white. Again, apply the same effect. So just press double click and then apply drop shadow. Apply another drop shadow. It's okay. And do the same thing by pressing Alt option and then copy that FX and paste it over here. Now after adding the text, next step we're going to create our follower. To do that, just we're going to take a shape and create a shape over here. Then if I zoom closer, you can see there is some ball over here. I'm going to click and drag to create a circle for the shape. And then you can also find that just in the properties panel over here, you can see it's a 16 pixel. It's okay. Now I'm going to decrease the opacity over here, like a fill. And I think it's okay. Next, we're going to apply drop shadow. To do that, just press over, double click over here. Then again, apply the drop shadow. Now this time, we're going to add another drop shadow. I think one drop shadow is okay. Then I'm going to introduce a color like inner glow. And it's okay. Again, just decrease the fill a little bit more. And I think it's okay right now. And now we are good to go. Then we're going to type a letter over here, follower. And then make it a smaller and place it over here. I'm going to use monster font. And then I'm going to increase the gap of the text and change the font color into black. Not a full black, something like this one. And then just place it and do the same thing by select these two layer and text and press Alt or Option on your keyboard and then click and drag. And I think it's okay. Now next step is to just color grade everything and make it perfect. First we're going to color grade our model image, like my image, then go to the filter and we're going to use the camera filter. This time I'm going to go to the basic and here I'm going to increase the highlights, decrease the shadows, and also I'm going to decrease the blacks. I'm going to highlight a little bit and then go to texture, clarity, and also the edge. This time go to the details over here. Can see there is a lot of details. I'm going to reduce the noise and you can see it's make the smoothness, reduce the color noise, and then go to the color mixer. Here we're going to adjust that over yellowish on the face. I think it's okay now for me, and I think just hit okay. Next we're going to again apply a drop shadow for the model. Just double click over here, apply drop shadow, and I think one drop shadow is perfectly all right. Then again we're going to color grade everything in by chance this one. Now press shift control alt e on a keyboard and create a snapshot, and then press the right button on the mouse and convert that into smart object. Now again go to the filter, camera filter. This time we're going to color grade everything all over the image. And then this is fine. And now you can see we're almost done to recreate that Ali Abdal thumbnails. Now I just want to show you all the process that what you can do to create Ali Abdal style of thumbnails, and just what the process that Ali Abdal can also do when it's come to creating thumbnails. His thumbnail is very simple and very easy way to create, but the process is just want to just highlight at your model or yourself. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit that like button and also let me know what the next creator you like to follow and what the next creator thumbnails you like want me to just to recreate and show you all the process. And if you face any kind of problem, you can just let me in the comments below. I will try my best to reply you and solve you the problem. You can also join into our Discord group where you can just connect me with personally, and also you can just contact me on Facebook or Instagram. So just follow there and stay with our channel. So that's it for today. See you in my next video. Till then, bye.